Hello, students. Are we ready for the next problem? All right, let's do it. And it says, John goes to tutorials in a math center. He pays a monthly membership and a certain amount per hour. The table below shows the situation. So, let's read the question. Based on this information, which of the following statements is true? So let's see, what do I know? Well, we know that he pays a monthly membership. Is that right? But he also pays so much money per hour. Very good. So what does it mean by monthly membership? Well, it means that regardless of the number of hours that he goes for tutorials, he needs to pay so much money a month. And of course, the next one is, how much money will he pay per hour? That, we don't know it yet. Let's analyze the table. So in the table, it says that when he goes for 2 hours, the total payment that he does is $90. But when he goes for 4 hours, the total is $140, and so on and so forth. So one of the things that you probably did in seventh grade, I hope you remember, is to find out what we call the change of the X and the change of the Y. And the way that we do that is by saying, how do you go from a 2 to a 4? Well, I'm adding 2. From 4 to a 6, you add in 2, and so on and so forth. Is that right? So the last one is from 10 to a 20 is actually plus 20. So I'm not going to look into that one. I'm going to look at the first four because it's a constant. It's going by twos. What about on the other side? Can you tell me what do you do to go from a 90 to a 140? I hope you think about plus 50, right? Yes? How about from 140 to 190? Yes, it's still a plus 50. And what about the next one? So through the whole time, it goes by 50. Now, why am I doing this? Because I want you to think about the opposite. To go the opposite direction means, how do I go from a 4 to a 2? Well, instead of adding, I'm going to subtract. Is that right? So I'm going to take away or subtract 2 minus 2. What's 2 minus 2? I'm going to write it down up here. It's a 0, right? So instead of adding to go forward, I'm going to go backwards. So I'm going to take away 90 minus 50. What's 90 minus 50? 40. So what does that mean? That means that before you even go to the tutorials for any hours, you're already paying $40. So what do you think the 40 represents? I hope that you're thinking that that's more than likely the monthly membership. Very good. Okay? I can also consider the numbers that I found on my table as the change of Y over the change of X. Is that right? So my change of Y is a 50. My change of X is a 2. If I simplify that, I will get 25 over 1. And we're going to come back to that 25 over 1 in a minute, okay? So what I want to do next is I actually want to find the slope, okay? So the slope, you'll find it by using a formula that is on your reference material, which says N equals Y sub 2 minus Y sub 1 over X sub 2 minus X sub 1. So I'm going to choose 2 points from the ones given to me. So I will choose 2 and 90. And I'm also going to choose 4 and 140. Okay? Let's write our labels, right? So my labels will be X sub 1 and Y sub 1 because that's my first point. On the second point, I will write down X sub 2 and Y sub 2. Okay, so let's circle my y coordinates. And now let's go ahead and apply that on my formula. So I have n equals 140 minus 90 over 4 minus 2. If I work on my question, I will get 50 over 2. I don't know if you noticed, but that 50 over 2, I can see it already. Isn't it on the other side of my problem where I put change of y over the change of x? Very good. So let's continue. What about if I want to simplify that? Well, that will give me a 25. But remember, 25 is the same as 25 over 1. Okay? So I found m to be my slope, if you remember. Okay? So what about the y-intercept? Well, the y-intercept would be when I actually do the equation of a slope-intercept form, which is y equals mx plus b, I need to choose a point. And the point that I want to choose, it can be any of the points that are on my table. So I'm choosing 2 and 90, where 2 is x and 90 is your y. So let's replace the values. The y value, replacing the y, will be 90. What about m? Well, we agree that m is 25, x is 2, and then plus b. So let's continue. What's 25 times 2? It's a 50 plus b. Very good. So let's go ahead and take away 50 on both sides. Because remember, you want to leave b by itself. Whatever you do on one side, do it to the other side. So this cancels out the 50, and it leaves the letter b, or my b by itself. 90 minus 50 is 40. So what does that mean? It means that b is 40, and if you remember, this is the same as your y-intercept. Is that right? Okay, so let's write down the equation. I'm going to write down y equals mx plus b, and I will replace m with a 25, and I will replace b with a 40. So, what does that mean? Well, the 25 means how much money he pays per hour. And 40 is actually the monthly membership. Very good. Let me write it down. Okay, notice how 40, we had already seen it before. And we saw it earlier when I did the table. So when x was 0, that was my monthly membership. What about 25? Well, 25 was the slope, and that's actually how much money you pay per hour. Very good. So let's look at the answer choices. Let's see if you can find which one represents that. Do you find it? It cannot be letter A, because letter A says the membership has a cost of $25 monthly. And we know that that's not true. It's actually $40. So keep on reading the answer choices. Did you find the one that matches our problem? Yes, the answer should be letter D. Very good, guys.